Happy Mother's Day and welcome to St. Vincent de Paul Catholic Parish. Our celebrant today is Monsignor David LeSueur, concelebrating his father Mike John, assisted by deacons Ronnie Hoyt and Arturo Castrillon. Please stand and let us glorify our Heavenly Father by singing, "This is Amazing Grace."
Breaks the power of sin and darkness, whose love is mighty and so much stronger. King of glory, the King above all kings, who shakes the whole earth with holy thunder and leaves them breathless in awe and wonder. The King of glory, the King above all kings. This is amazing grace. This is unfailing love. That you would take my place. That you would bear my cross. Lay down your you've done for me. All that you've done for me.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. May the grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the community of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
It's so good to see you here this morning. I welcome you back. We had maybe 100 people at the 4 o'clock Mass yesterday, and maybe 300 at the 6. There's a good crowd here today, so I want to welcome you back. And could you please give each other a little round of applause and thank the Lord, too. So. This being the Easter season, we want to remind ourselves of our baptism into Christ. So, my brothers and sisters, let us humbly beseech the Lord's mercy. And this water, which he has created, will be sprinkled on us as a memorial of our baptism. May he help us with his grace to remain faithful to the Spirit that we have received.
You call me out upon the waters, the great unknown, where feet may fail. And there I find you in the mystery, in oceans deep, my faith will stand. And I will call upon your name and keep my eyes above the waves. When oceans rise, my soul will rest in your embrace, for I am yours and you are mine. Your grace abounds in deepest waters. Your sovereign hand will be my guide. Where feet may fail and fear surrounds me, you've never failed, and you won't start now. And I will call upon you. winds rise, my soul will rest in your embrace, for I am yours, and you are mine.
May Almighty God cleanse us of our sins, and through the celebration of this Eucharist, make us worthy to share at the table of his kingdom. Amen.
Glory to God in the highest,
and on earth
peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory, Lord God, heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son. Take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father.
Let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, constantly accomplish the paschal mystery within us that you have pleased to make new in holy baptism. May your protective care bear much fruit and come to the joys of eternal life through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. As the number of disciples continued to grow, the Hellenists complained against the Hebrews because their widows were being neglected in the daily distribution. So the 12 called together the community of the disciples and said, "It is not right for us to neglect the word of God to serve at table. Brothers, select from among you 7 reputable men, filled with the Spirit and wisdom, whom we shall appoint to this task, whereas we shall devote ourselves to prayer and to the ministry of the word." The proposal was acceptable to the whole community, so they chose Stephen, a man filled with faith and the Holy Spirit, also Philip, Prochorus, Nicanor, Timon, Parmenas, and Nicholas of Antioch, a convert to Judaism. They presented these men to the apostles, who prayed and laid hands on them. The word of God continued to spread, and the number of the disciples in Jerusalem increased. Even a large group of priests were becoming obedient to the faith. The word of the Lord. A reading from the first letter of St. Peter. Beloved, come to him, a living stone, rejected by human beings, but chosen and precious in the sight of God. And like living stones, let yourselves be built into a spiritual house, to be a holy priesthood, to offer spiritual sacrifices acceptable to God through Jesus Christ. For it says in Scripture, behold, I am laying a stone in Zion, a cornerstone, chosen and precious, and whoever believes in it shall not be put to shame. Therefore, value is for you who have faith. But for those without faith, the stone that the builders rejected has become the cornerstone, a stone that will make people stumble, and a rock that will make they stumble by disobeying the word, as is their destiny. You are a chosen race, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, a people of his own, so that you may announce the praises of him who called you out of darkness into his wonderful light. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading of the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said to his disciples, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. You have faith in God. Have faith also in me. In my Father's house there are many dwelling places. If there are not, would I have told you that I am going to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come back again and take you to myself, so that where I am, you also may be. Where I am going, you know the way." Thomas said to him, "Master, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way?" Jesus said to him, "I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. If you know me, then you will also know my Father. From now on, you do know him and have seen him." Philip said to him, "Master, show us the Father, and that will be enough for us." Jesus said to him, "Have I been with you for so long a time, and you still do not know me, Philip? Whoever has seen me has seen the Father. How can you say, 'Show us the Father'? Do you not believe that I am the Father and the Father is in me? The words that I speak to you, I do not speak on my own. The Father who dwells in me is doing his works. Believe me that I am in the Father and the Father is in me, or else believe because of the works themselves. Amen, amen, I say to you, whoever believes in me will do the works that I do, and will do greater ones than these, because I am going to the Father." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Well, it's so good to stand before you again and speak with you about God's Word. I feel like I just want to talk with you. But before I get into that, I want you to know that I will not be giving out communion today because, according to the bishop's orders, those over 65 should not be giving out communion. So I'm beyond 65, so that's why I will not be distributing communion to you as much as I would love to. But anyway, you know, we've been separated for a long time, 2 months. I think the last time we had Mass together was like the first weekend of March, which was also the second Sunday of Lent. So it's been a long time, and it's so good to see you together. And even though we're still not totally together because we're sitting separately in family units or couple units, and that's okay, but you can still see some of the results of our having been separated by the way we're seated tonight or this morning at church. But that, again, at least we're here. We're in the body of Christ. We are the body of Christ. And you know, ultimately, you cannot separate the body of Christ because we are one in Christ. And Christ is our unity, and so is the Holy Spirit. It's the Spirit that makes us one. In fact, we are the unity of the Holy Spirit. I began Mass by saying, "May the grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the community or the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you. And so the fellowship of the Holy Spirit is really us. We are that joined unity because we're baptized into one Spirit. I like to compare what we've been going through, the separation, to flour. Not the flour that grows in your garden, but the sack of flour you buy at your store to bake with. You know, if you take a handful of flour and blow on it, poof, it goes all over the place. You make a big mess because it's dry. So what makes the flour adhere? What makes it one mass, so to speak? It's water. And so it's the water that joins together those grains of flour that themselves come from many hundreds or thousands of grains of wheat, ground, sifted, put into one sack, one unity until you take it out. You blow on it, it scatters. You put water in it, it stays together. And that's what keeps you and I together as the body of Christ, water. The water of baptism and the water of the Holy Spirit. So yes, we're still wearing masks. We're separated in that sense. Because it's interesting, we don't want to breathe on each other. And normally we do. You know, we talk to each other, we exchange breath as we talk and converse and so on. But right now we can't do that for safety's sake. That's not normal. You and I often, when we talk close to each other, when couples talk to each other, or couples talk with their children, they share breath. But that's what God does for us as well. He shares his breath with us. Now, on the night of the resurrection, in John chapter 20, Jesus appears to his disciples, and he says, "Peace be with you." And then somewhere along in that conversation, he says, "As my Father has sent me, so I send you." And then what does he do? He breathes on them and says, "Receive the Holy Spirit." So the Spirit has been breathed into us by God, with the water and the words, "I baptize you in the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit." So at the moment of baptism, you and I receive that Spirit. And we are therefore joined together in the body of Christ by that same Spirit. But the Spirit is breathed into us. So what did God do in the Garden of Eden? He took a mass of clay, or maybe dry dust. He shaped it into a human form, but then what did he do? He breathed into it. He breathed into it the breath of life. And that lump of clay or that scattered dust became a human being. We call him Adam. And the word Adam is a Hebrew word meaning dirt, soil. So you and I are part of the soil, and when we die, we return to our dust. But God breathes life and unity into us by his love. I was looking at the 7th chapter of Ezekiel. It's one of my favorite chapters in that prophet's speech because it takes place during the exile in Babylon. And Ezekiel is in Babylon. He is a prophetic person in that exile. He was told in a vision one time to view a valley full of dried bones. These bones represented the people of Israel because they were scattered. They were in exile, but they were scattered from their home. And they were like dried bones. They were dead, spiritually dead. So the voice of God said to Ezekiel, "Ezekiel, prophesy to these bones and tell them to come together." So they hear this rattling sound in this valley of death, and this rattling sound of the bones coming back together, and then pretty soon flesh and sinews and tendons come together, and you see these bodies, but they're dead. At least they have flesh now, and they've come back together into unified form, but they're still lifeless. And so then God said to Ezekiel, "Prophesy to the wind, the four winds, and tell them to bring life back into these bodies." The word for wind in Hebrew is ruah, which means breath or spirit or wind. It can mean any of those things. And so he's saying, prophesy to the Spirit, and tell the Spirit to come back to give life to these lifeless bodies. And so again, that's what happens. They came back to life, and that represented the new life of the people of Israel. Excuse me. So you and I, excuse me again. Nothing to do with COVID. I have phlegm in my throat in the mornings, probably because of the cough. Anyway, you and I have been scattered. We've not been dead, but we've been scattered by this COVID-19 thing, and it's only for protection. I understand that, but in a way, we have missed being together like this in our church with one another. I've seen some of you for many weeks, 2 months. I haven't seen some of you physically with my eyes. It's so good to see you. And I know you feel that way about one another, people you normally sit next to at Mass. Well, we've been scattered, and yet the breath of the Spirit has been given to us in baptism. We've been scattered physically, but not spiritually. Now, let me say a word about that flour again, or the dust. You know, when I was a kid, I made mud pies. And again, you get dust, you put water with it, you have this cohesive lump of mud, but it's cohesive, it stays together. What you do, you put it in the sun to let it bake till it dries out. Well, when it dries out, if you break it, it becomes dust again, right? So what I'm saying is we need to be back together, because if we get separated from one another, not just physically, and we've had good reasons for being separated, but when we eventually wander away from our faith, and some people will not come back, because I think some people, literally, if honest, have been looking for reasons not to come to church. And the bishop has given them one. You don't have to come to church. Now you may, but you don't have to. And some people will take that and say, good, I don't have to go now, because I've been given permission by the bishop. They may never come back. But what happens is they break off, and it's possible for them spiritually to dry up and become dust. We don't want that. So if you know someone among your family members or your friends or so on, invite them, encourage them. Don't force them. Don't make them feel guilty, but encourage them to come back to join the body. I keep going on about this. Last week, we had the Good Shepherd reading from John chapter 10. Every fourth Sunday of Easter is always about the Good Shepherd. And he says, you know, the thief comes into the sheepfold by another way. He jumps over the fence. He doesn't come in through the gate. And what does he do? He scatters the sheep. What does a wolf do? He eats the sheep. He scatters them, makes them run away. The Good Shepherd, however, leads them together. He walks in. He calls them by name. They follow him because they know his voice. They're together because the Good Shepherd leads us together. COVID-19, in a way, has separated us. It's kind of scattered us. But it doesn't have to be the end. We have a shepherd. We have a voice that has called us to new life, who's given us life in the water and the Spirit. We have the Spirit together with us, bringing us together. So, brothers and sisters, it's so good to see you again. We'll come back in greater numbers in the coming weeks. But if you know somebody who hasn't been coming, even before the COVID thing started, invite them, family members, at least pray for them, that they will not dry up, that they will not become separated from us because they don't understand or don't want to come. They have their reasons. But we thank the Lord for bringing us together today and in the coming weeks, breathing his Spirit into us, baptizing us with his Spirit, watering us with his love. So, Lord, help us to grow. Help us to grow individually, of course, but also as a community, a family, a parish, as your body in the world today. And as you breathe your Spirit into your disciples on the night of resurrection, and you sent them out as your Father sent you, Lord, begin to send us back into the world with a commission to bring your love to others. We pray this in your holy name. Amen. Let us rise and profess our faith. We believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead. I have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I believe for the forgiveness of sins. I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. With faith, let us turn now to our Heavenly Father, pleading that he hear these prayers.
For our church to continue to reach out to those on the margins of society, serving as a witness to the world in how to care for even the least in our midst, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For peaceful resolutions to the challenges that face our world, such as hunger, poverty, climate change, and especially the coronavirus pandemic, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For healthcare workers, first responders, all who are caring for the needs of those who are suffering from COVID-19, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all deacons and for all who minister to the church and the world through selfless acts of service, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our mothers, grandmothers, aunts, and all who served as mothers to us, both living and to those who have passed on to eternal life, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the faithful departed, especially Ustiloli Cosio, Jesus Ugaldi, Maria del Carmen Ramirez Bello, Nicholas Manos, and Andy Andresen, be with our Savior in paradise. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all the sick, for our private intentions, and for all those written in the book of prayers, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Heavenly Father, in your mercy, you have sent to us your Son, Jesus. And so now, in his name, we ask that you hear these prayers, for he lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Surely you smiled when he arrived. The moment you first kissed his holy face. Surely you wept at his face. Beautiful. who could better understand when we weep or we worry, when we fail or we fly? We are beautiful mothers, beautiful in His eyes.
I pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. O God, who by the wonderful exchange effected in this sacrifice have made us partakers of the one supreme Godhead, grant, we pray, that as we have come to know your truth, we may make it ours by a worthy way of life, through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and all times, to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all, to laud you yet more gloriously when Christ, our Passover, has been sacrificed. Through him, the children of light rise to eternal life, and the halls of the heavenly kingdom are thrown open to the faithful. For his death is our ransom from death, and his rising is our rising to new life. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise. And even the heavenly powers, the angelic hosts, sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. Indeed, holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven. And as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ.
May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and all your saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help.
May the sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis our Pope and Anthony our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own.
Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world, to our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life. Here, let us remember our mothers and those who have gone before us. Give kind admittance to your kingdom, to them, O Lord. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. And graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Let me just make one brief announcement. I'm sorry. Before we go further, we have a couple of restrictions that we have to abide by when it comes time for communion. So I'd just like to go over those before we come forward. First, just a word of gratitude to you all. Thank you very much for wearing masks to be here. I know it's a little bit uncomfortable. All of us on the altar will put masks on in order to give out communion. The way that it will work is as follows. Just pay attention to the ushers. They will come forward and you'll be dismissed pew by pew. We'll have one communion line per aisle. And so we've got X's on the floor. I just ask that when you're in line, just stand on an X, and that way everyone will be 6 feet apart. So everyone won't get in the line at once. The ushers will kind of go pew by pew to make sure that we stay at a safe distance. The bishop has asked that you please receive communion in the hand and not on the tongue, just as a way to be safe. And I know that's a sacrifice for some, but we ask your cooperation there. So please receive on the hand and no gloves, okay? Which that doesn't look like many people have gloves. So when you come forward to receive communion, there's just a very simple three-step process that will follow. So all you'll do when you come forward is step forward to the minister. Step one is lower your mask. Step two, extend your hands and then receive communion. And then step three is just raise your mask. Okay, so three steps. Come forward, step one, lower your mask. Step two, extend your hands and consume the Eucharist. Step three, raise your mask.
God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Savior, I come, quiet my soul, remember redemption's hill where your blood was spilled for my ransom. Everything I once held dear, I count to the cross where your love poured out. Bring me to my knees, Lord, I lay me down. Rid me of myself, I belong to you. Oh, lead me. Lead me to the cross. You were as I tempted and tried, human. The Word became flesh, bore my sin and death. Now you're risen. Cross where your love poured out. Bring me to my knees, Lord, I lay me down. Rid me of myself, I belong to you. Oh, lead me, lead me to the cross. Savior, I come, quiet my soul. Remember redemption's hill where your blood was spilled for my ransom. Everything I once held dear, I count it all as loss. Lead me to the cross where your love poured out. Bring me to my knees, Lord, I lay me down. Rid me of myself, I belong to you. Only tempted and tried, human. The Word became flesh, bore my sin and death. Now you're risen. Everything I once held dear, I count it all as loss. Lead me to the cross where your love poured out. Bring me to my knees, Lord, I lay me down. Rid me of myself, I belong. Lead me to the cross.
Please be seated for our announcements. I'll do the Mother's Day blessing first.
Okay. Hello, my name is Raydell Klostmeyer, and these are today's announcements. The month of May is dedicated to the Blessed Virgin Mary. To honor our Mother Mary and all mothers, we invite you, anytime this week, to bring cut flowers and place them at the Marian Shrine in the entrance roundabout of the church. Unfortunately, we were not able to celebrate our scheduled First Communion and Confirmation Masses, nor were we able to initiate those who prepared to enter the Catholic Church at the Easter Vigil. We are working on plans to schedule these sacraments throughout the upcoming months. All those involved will be contacted once plans are finalized for each of these sacraments. Thank you for your patience, and please know that you remain in our prayers. Thank you.
I ask you to remain seated for this closing prayer because I spoke too soon about having the announcements before this prayer. So just remain seated as we pray. Graciously be present to your people, we pray, O Lord, and lead those you have imbued with heavenly mysteries to pass from former ways of newness to life through Christ our Lord. Amen. I'd like to ask the mothers, please, to rise. Moms, thank you so much for what you do for your families and for our parish. We know that some moms aren't here today. They're watching on television. And some moms are already in heaven, like mine. So I want to thank you for who you are, what you do, and how you have always been there for your kids. So I'd like to offer this prayer especially for you. On this Mother's Day, let us pray for our mothers. Loving God, as a mother gives life and nourishment to her children, so watch over your church. Bless these women, that they may be strengthened as Christian mothers. Let the example of their faith and love shine forth. Grant that we may honor them always with a spirit of profound respect. This we ask through Christ our Lord. Amen. And may Almighty God bless you, moms, in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. And now we have some instructions for the end of Mass. Father Mike.
Thanks, Monsignor. Just some brief instructions on how we're going to handle the dismissal for Mass. So just again, per the bishop's requirements, the idea is to avoid bunching up into groups of people. So once again, the ushers will dismiss you pew by pew. All of the doors to the church are open, so you can leave through any exit you choose, but just please wait until the ushers tell you that it's okay to leave. Again, just because we're trying to avoid bunching up into groups, the priests and deacons, we're not really available after Mass for like to bless things or for conversation. You can wave to us at a distance, but we have to wait a little bit longer until some of these restrictions are lifted. Because we can now have Mass in public, we, just for the time being, this is not a permanent schedule, just for the time being, Masses open to the public are available daily at 11:30 in English and 12:30 in Spanish here in the main worship space. So every day at 11:30 and 12:30 we will have Mass. Next weekend we'll have the same schedule that we had this weekend. So two Masses Saturday evening, two Masses Sunday morning. So this is just our phase one Mass schedule, so just stay tuned on our Facebook or bulletin. We'll have all of the Mass times updated in there. As announced, because of the restrictions, First Communions, Confirmations, Quinceañeras, and so on and so forth have had to be postponed. As soon as we receive permission, first of all from the governor and then from the bishop, that we can sort of lift some of these restrictions, we'll be able to schedule concretely First Communion Masses, Confirmation Masses. So just keep praying that that can happen soon. Thank you again for your patience as we gather together. It's not quite back to normal yet, but we're getting there. So thank you again.
Thank you, Father Mike. Also, we used to have daily adoration here in the church. That has been moved now to the daily Mass chapel. The Blessed Sacrament will be exposed every morning at 6 o'clock, and every evening it will be reposed at 10 o'clock. So all day long, you're welcome to come and make a visit to our Lord Jesus and the Blessed Sacrament in the daily Mass chapel. Let us rise, please. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow down for the blessing. The God who, by the resurrection of his only begotten Son, was pleased to confer on you the gift of redemption and adoption, give you gladness by his blessing. Amen.
Amen.
May he who, by a redeeming work, you have received the gift of everlasting freedom, make you heirs to an eternal inheritance. Amen.
Amen.
May you, who have already risen with Christ, been baptized through faith, by living in a right manner on this earth, be united with him in the homeland of heaven. Amen.
Amen.
And may the blessings of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit descend upon you and remain forever.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.
Water you turned into wine, open the eyes of the blind, there's no one like you, none like you. Into the darkness you shine, out of the ashes we rise, there's no one like you, none like you. Our God is greater, our God is stronger, God, you are higher than any other. Our God is healer, awesome in power, our God, our God. Our God is greater, our God is stronger, God, you are higher than any other. Our God is healer, awesome in power, our God, our God. And if our God is for us, then who could ever stop us? And if our God is with us, then what could stand against? And if our God is for us, then who could ever stop us? And if our God is with us, then what could stand against? What could stand against? Our God is greater, our God is stronger, God, you are higher than any other. Our God is healer, awesome in power, our God, our God. Our God is greater, our God is stronger, God, you are higher than any other. Our God is healer, awesome in power, our God. God.